ओम अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशालाकाय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमः विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रसारिणी निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणी। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंदा। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम रामा हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम रामा हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम रामा हरे हरे। So welcome everybody for chapter 12, the Bhakti Yoga. So total out of 18 chapters, first 6 chapters is regarding karma, and next 6 chapters, 7 to 12 chapter is regarding bhakti, and 13 onwards, 13 to 18 is regarding jnana, jnana yoga. So 7 to 12 is regarding bhakti yoga. But out of that, 12th chapter is most important because it is the essence of Bhakti Yoga. The chapter itself is Bhakti Yoga. What is devotional service? Bhakti Yoga or devotional service? What is the devotional service? How we can practice the devotional service? That is the main purpose of this chapter. Okay. Tanmay, are you ready? Hare Krishna.
Tanmay, yes, you can unmute.
Unmute.
Arjuna uvacha evam satata yuktaye bhaktastvam paryupasate ye cha pyaksharam avyaktam Desham ke yoga vittamaha. Translation.
Okay. Acha, this translation will be Rishik will read the translation. Rishik.
Yeah, one minute. Prabhuji, I think we had, I think there was someone else, right, who had given the name.
Yes, Rishik.
Rishik Surya and Sai Krishna. Half will read by Rishik. And another half by Sai Krishna.
Yeah, yeah. Translation. Arjuna inquired, which are considered to be more perfect? Those who are always properly engaged in your devotional service, or those who worship the impersonal Brahman, the unmanifested?
Okay. So what exactly here Arjuna is asking, a very important question. That which is considered to be more perfect. So God has been worshipped in different forms. Some people telling God is personal, like beautiful form. Some people telling God is formless. Okay, so Arjun got confused and asked the question to Krishna that who is better, which is perfect? Who are always properly engaged in your devotional service, or those who worship the impersonal Brahman, the unmanifested? Krishna told in previously that with my impersonal feature, I have pervaded the whole universe, entire universe. You cannot see. So that form is formless. But Krishna has got an original form, the beautiful two-handed form. So usually the devotee, they concentrate, meditate on this two-handed form. And few people, they are imperson, they concentrate, meditate on the impersonal form. Those are called impersonalists. Krishna is asking, who is better? The devotee who meditate on two-handed form is better, or the person who meditate on the impersonal feature of the Lord, who is better? Let's see what Krishna is telling. Yes. So this we have already discussed previously in the second chapter. Now, God has got three forms, Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan. Brahman means it is formless. Those people who are long distance from the Krishna, long distance, they perceive Lord as a light. This light is the light covering the Lord, which is called Brahma Yoti. You see from long distance, it's just like a spot of light. But as you go closer and closer, you can see the Paramatma. Paramatma is situated in everybody's heart at super soul. At super soul is Paramatma. But you go still closer, you can see the beautiful form of Lord, the 200 Krishna, which is called Bhagavan form. So there are three different types of form. Depending upon our association with Lord, we'll perceive that form. Okay? Now this is, you see, he's asking, what are you doing? This Baba is telling, focusing. On what? Not sure. So, impersonal feature, the person who meditates on the impersonal Brahman, they usually do not know where they are focusing, on what they are meditating. You'll ask, what you are doing? I'm meditating. On what you are meditating? I'm not sure. Because they usually meditate on a light, or they want to vacate their mind, but which is not possible. So it's really confusing what they are doing. Now here, the prescribed dharma in four yuga. So you know there are four yuga, Satya, Tritya, and Dwapar Kali. So as per literature, there are different type of spiritual progression in different yuga, and those are different spiritual process. In Satya Yoga, the spiritual process is meditation. In Tritya Yoga, it is the sacrifice. In Dwapar Yoga, it is the temple worship. Whereas in Kali Yoga, it is the only chanting. So if in Kali Yoga you want to do meditation, it won't work. Or in Dwapar Yuga, you will do sacrifice, it won't work. So these are the prescribed spiritual process for different yoga. Yes, in Kali Yuga, we are also doing temple worship. We are also doing sacrifice. We are also doing meditation. But the only process which is best working in this yoga is chanting only. Sacrifice, worship, we can do, but it won't work that much in this yoga. Okay, because this is the prescribed process, devotional service, devotional process in Kali Yuga. Next.
Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Maye Veshya Mano Ye Mam Nitya Yukta Upasate Shraddhaya Parayopeta Teme Yukta Tama Mataha.
Yes. Very sick.
Translation. The Supreme Personality of God, Godhead said, those who fix their minds on my personal form and are always engaged in worshipping me with great and transcendental faith and are considered by me to be most perfect.
Yes. So Arjuna is asking who is perfect? Who is focusing on the personal form? Or who is focusing on the impersonal feature, some light. So here Krishna is giving very clear cut answer. Those people who fix their mind on my personal form, that is a two-handed form, and are always engaged in the worshipping me with great and transcendental faith are considered by me to be the most perfect. So the concept is very clear. The person who worship and meditate on the two-handed form, the beautiful form of Lord, is the greatest. Not that the person who is focusing on the impersonal Brahman, like light, mind, heart. Okay, so many people are concentrating, meditating on different features, different forms. So they are not great. The greatest is who is focusing on the personal form of the Lord. Okay? Here you see, what is the personal form of God? The beautiful two-handed form, Krishna, is the personal form of God. This is a beautiful Radha Damodara deity in ISKCON Mangaluru. So beautiful, Krishna. Next.
Klesho dikatarastesham avyakta sakta cetasam avy व्यक्ता हिगते दुःखहं देहवद् बिरवाप्यते.
Translation: For those whose minds are attached to the unmanifested impersonal feature of the Supreme, advancement is very troublesome.
Yes. So again, Krishna is telling, some people they focus on the impersonal feature, some people on personal form. He's telling those person who focus on the impersonal feature, unmanifested form, their advancement in spirituality is very difficult, very troublesome, because they themselves do not know where they are going. They're confused. Okay? See, this is one meditator who concentrated or meditated on the impersonal form, some light and something. He's telling, I'll go to mountain and focus on Brahman. Okay, Brahman means impersonal form of Lord. Brahman, Paramatma, Bhagavan. So Brahman is impersonal form, that is the light, which is the light surrounding the God. That is called Brahma Yoti. So now, then he is very confused. It's too cold. If you go to some place, I'll go to the desert and focus on the Brahman. It's too hot. So these people are very confused. I'll go to the forest and focus on Brahman. What if tiger comes me, attacks me? So that means they are not focused directly, strictly on the God, because they don't have any concept of God. They don't focus on the personal feature of God, the beautiful form of Krishna. They focus on some light. That is the reason they are very confused. And Krishna is directly informing us that those people who concentrate on my impersonal feature, their progression in spirituality is very difficult, very troublesome. What can I do in Kali Yuga? Because already we have discussed in four yoga, different spiritual process. In Kali Yuga is Harinam. Harinam, 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 Aiva Kevalam, Kalaunasti, Ivanasti, Ivanasti, Vagatir Anyatha. In the age of Kali, the only way of deliverance is Harinam, Harinam. There is no other way, no other way, no other way. Ivanasti, Ivanasti, Iva Gatiranya. There is no other way, no other way, no other way. Only way is to take the Harinam or chant the Harinam. Okay? So what is that Harinam? Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Already we have discussed why this mantra is important in Kali Yuga. Already we have discussed. So in Kali Yuga, after so many name of Hari, this mantra has been designed for Kali Yuga, because it is so powerful, it will destroy all the sin of Kali Yuga. Okay? Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So they are so peaceful and happy by chanting this name. I think this sloka will be read by Shiva. Hare Krishna.
Yes, Shiva Chandramouli.
Yes, Shiva Chandramouli. Can read this.
Hare Krishna, Guruji.
Yes.
Yes, Guruji. Mayeva mana adashva, mayi buddhim niveshaya, nivasi shama mayeva, ata urvadamna samsaya. Sir, translation.
Translation: Just fix your mind upon me, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and engage all your intelligence in me. Thus you will live in me always, without a doubt.
Yes. So again, the Krishna is giving emphasis again and again, again and again. Thus you always meditate on my personal form. If you meditate on my impersonal form, then it is very difficult. So he is telling again, fix your mind upon me, the Supreme Personality Godhead, engage all your intelligence on me. So that means your full concentration should be there in my personal form, my beautiful two-handed form, not on my impersonal feature. Okay? Thus you will live in me always without a doubt. So So here in this picture, can anyone tell who are these persons?
Prabhu Hare Krishna.
You unmute someone.
Prabhuji and Prabhuji.
Yeah. Yes.
Prabhuji, the sleeping one is Lord Krishna.
Yes,
and sitting one is Duryodhan.
Yes.
And standing one is Arjuna. They are asked he should send his army to them.
Yes, yes. So for Mahabharata Yuddha, they came for help to Arjuna. So to Krishna. Okay, Arjuna also came, Duryodhana also came. Arjuna is so humble, he was sitting near the foot end. But Duryodhana is very proud, so that's why he was sitting near the head end. Okay, so here what happened, Krishna is telling, my army will be on one side and I'll be on other side and I won't fight. So that was the condition of Krishna. Now, he wanted to give chance Arjuna first. So what Arjuna told? We want you and my Lord, you my Lord, not your army. That means Arjuna wanted Krishna only in at any condition. Okay, so that should be the goal. Our nature should be like that. We want Krishna in any condition. And Duryodhana is telling, what a non-intelligent person. Because he was thinking the army, the great army of Krishna is so powerful that he should ask that one. Why he asked Krishna that too, without weapons, he don't fight. Okay. So that is the difference between devotee and non-devotee. A true devotee wants nothing but the Lord, but a non-devotee wants the powers and other things. Okay, so our nature, aim, character should be like Arjuna, not like Duryodhana. 12.9 will be read by, I think, Tanmay only.
Ata chittam samadatum nashaknoshi mayistiram abhyasa yogena tataha mamipchaktam dananjaya.
Ajay, Sai Krishna is there. You are supposed to read the sloka.
No, Aditi, Sai Krishna is not there.
Is not there. Then.
Yes, Prabhuji, I'm trying to unmute him. Sai Krishna. Prabhuji, I can't find him actually.
Prabhuji, can I read this also?
Ritik, na? Rishik.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay, then you continue.
Yeah.
Translation. My dear Arjuna, O winter of wealth, if you cannot fix your mind upon me without deviation, then follow the regulative principles of bhakti yoga. In this way, develop a desire to attain me.
So Krishna is giving here different options. He's telling first an important thing is directly focus on me undeviatedly. But for some people it is difficult. Okay, so he's giving another option. So if it is difficult for you to fix the mind upon me, what you have to do? Follow the regulative principle of bhakti yoga. So what is the regulative principle? Acharya has given, there are four regulative principles. One is no meat eating, no gambling, no intoxication, no illicit sex. So these four is to be removed if you are not able to concentrate directly on the personal feature of Lord Krishna. And slowly you will be purified and you'll be able to concentrate on me. So that is second option Krishna is giving. You can see here, the blue part is Suddha Bhakti. So directly you have reached the God. And if you cannot do this, then God is telling you, follow the regulative principle. Now, regulative principle, if you follow, there is a maya, illusion in between. So you'll be able to destroy the illusion and slowly you can come into the Suddha Bhakti. Then you can focus on me and you can come to me. So regulative principle is, if you follow, you can also destroy the maya or illusion and come to the level of bhakti. Okay? So So this is what second option Krishna is giving. And that also if you cannot do, next loka Shiva Chandramali can read.
Hare Krishna.
Yes.
Yes, Rudi. Abhyase Piyamasa Piyasamartosi Mat Karma Paramos Bhava Madartam Api Karmani Kurvan Siddhyam Avapsyasi.
Yes. Rishik.
Rudi, translation.
Rishik.
Translation. If you cannot practice the regulations of Bhakti Yoga, then just try to work for me. Because by working for me, you will come to the perfect state.
Yes. So next Krishna is giving another option. First is you focus on me directly, but it is not possible for many people. Then he is telling if you are not able to do that, you follow the four regulative principles. If still you are not able to do that, this is the third option, that you work for me. Work for me means you can do a small work for me. You can go to temple, you can pluck the flower, you can do the garland, you can do a small work in the temple, you can donate something, you can distribute some prasadam. So all these are small activities going on in temple. So you can take part in anything. So you do something for me. And while doing this, you will be slowly purified. And Narada Muni in the previous birth, you know, great devotee Narada Muni, previous birth, he was born to a maid servant, a son of maid servant. But he got purified when he did small work for the devotees who are coming to the temple. Slowly he got purified and the next life he became a great devotee like Narada Muni. So that's what God is giving. The third option, you work for me and slowly you'll be able to concentrate on me and you'll get an option to come to me. You'll be perfect. It's the third option God is giving. So here you see there are difference between a devotee and the non-devotee. Non-devotee are always under the influence of Maya or illusion. Whereas devotee are very peaceful. They are very clear. Maya does not touch them. So because they are non-devotee are under illusion, under Maya. So he is telling, I'll buy a bigger phone, TV compared to my neighbor. That means he's envious. He's comparing with the neighbor because he's having this thing. I'll buy the thing which is better than my neighbor. So what is the reason for this? There is no reason. It's just enviousness. This is usually character of non-devotees. But a devotee is very clear in his goal. I'll buy a Gita. That means he'll buy something for certain purpose. Without purpose, just for enviousness, you buy something, it's useless. That a devotee knows very well. So that is the difference between a devotee and non-devotee. This translation, Rishik, you'll read.
Translation. One who is equal to friends and enemies, who is equipoised in honor and dishonor, heat and cold, happiness and distress, fame and infamy, who is always free from contaminating association, always silent and satisfied with anything, who doesn't care for any resident, who is fixed in knowledge and who is engaged in devotional service, such a person is very dear to me.
Yes. So Krishna is telling, this type of people are very dear to me. That means they don't have duality. Okay, what is the don't have duality is equal to friends and enemies. He behaves equally, friends and enemy. Equipoised to honor and dishonor. If you scold also, he won't react that much. If you give honor also, he won't react that much. Because he knows the reality. Heat and cold, he is equal. Happiness and distress, he is very peaceful. Fame and infinity, he don't like. So he is always free from contaminating association. Always silent, satisfied with anything. So whatever is there with him, he is satisfied. He do not want anything more. Everything, whatever he is having, he used for the service of the Lord. So that is called a pure devotee who doesn't care for any residence, who is fixed in knowledge, who is engaged in devotional service. So this type of pure devotee are very dearer to Krishna. Okay, Krishna is telling. So we should try to be like this devotee. We should not discriminate between friends and enemies. This is also pure devotee. Can anyone tell who is this person?
Okay, I'll tell you.
Yes.
There is
Vedanta Bhakti Swami. Prabhuji Vedanta Bhakti Swami.
Please don't
name. Bhakti Vedanta
Swami.
Swami. What is the name?
The name.
I don't know his full name.
Okay.
So you must know that, right? Okay, this, no problem. I'll okay. go to Priya Agarwal. Please unmute
Krishna. Sir, I think he is the main head of Gita. Sir, today was my chance of reading 12th adhyaya, but I didn't got any chance.
Okay, the 20th sloka you'll read. Next sloka.
Okay.
Last sloka. Okay.
So please don't mute yourself.
Okay. So can anyone tell who is this person? Today we are doing whatever this 18 days course and all, studying Gita, studying Bhagavatam. It is only because of this person.
Yes.
Who is he?
Okay, let me unmute one person. Sai Deepak Deep Yatha Deepu Iskon. Please unmute.
Prabhuji is Srila Prabhupada.
Yes, Jai Sri Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. So, what he did, he translated everything, many Vedic literature into English, because everything was written in Sanskrit. Because of that, many people are not able to read, not able to understand. So, he did a great service that he had translated everything to the English so that now everyone can understand what is the meaning. Okay? That's why we should be very, very grateful to him. And he has established the ISKCON. First he has established, he has tried a lot in India, but nobody cares him. Nobody likes him. So that's why he went to US, America. There he started ISKCON. Then when he came to India, everybody accepted. So that's what is our country. We don't recognize the person who is doing real service or who is not doing. Okay. Who is this person?
Narayana. Narayana.
Yes.
Please don't answer in the middle. If you want to answer.
Narada Muni, yes. So I just told Narada Muni. In the previous birth, Narada Muni was a son of maid servant. He became a pure devotee just by giving small service to the devotee. Small service to the devotee on the previous birth. He becomes so purified, he became a great devotee of Lord Vishnu. Okay.
Yeah, Prabhuji, I think you can go to
the leave it. This one, who will read?
Priya.
Priya will read. No? Okay, go on.
Ye tu dharma mritmedam yo tak तम परिपासते श्रद्धा दाना मत परमा भक्तास्तु अतीव मे प्रियः. Translation: those who follow this imperishable path of devotional service and who completely engage themselves with faith, making me the supreme goal, are very, very dearer to me.
Yes. So again, the Lord is telling, who follow the imperishable path of devotional service. That means, there are so many yoga we have discussed already. One is Jnana Yoga, then Karma Yoga, Dhyana Yoga, and Bhakti Yoga. So Krishna is telling the Bhakti Yoga is the best. And who follows this path of devotional service? Devotional service means Bhakti Yoga, path of devotional service. And who completely engages himself with faith, making me the supreme goal, is very dearer, or very dearer, or very, very dearer to me. Like Arjun. The only aim is to serve the Lord. Okay, so we should be like Arjun, not like Duryodhana. can see here is a great devotee, always chanting, worshipping, remembering Krishna. Okay, so he is very dearer to Krishna. Now here some people are torturing some person, devotee, but he's always thinking about the Krishna. He don't bother what is the response of people towards him. And when he leave the body, Krishna directly come and take him to the Krishna lok. Okay, so that is the nature of the devotee and love of Krishna towards the devotee. Who is this personality? Anyone tell?
Okay, just a minute.
Sir, he is Hanumanji.
Yes, Hanumanji and?
Hanuman.
Please don't. Can you please raise your hand? Because we have many people who want to. We can't only give chance to one, right?
Yes, Hanumanji and who?
Okay, now you answer, no problem. But next time, please remember.
Sir, Ramji and Hanumanji.
Yes, Sri Ram and Hanumanji. Who is in the middle? Anyone?
Narasimha Avatar.
Okay. Narasimha Avatar.
Yes.
Alaj.
Holding. Sir, I think he is Narasingha.
Holding to whom? This child?
Prahlad. Prahlad.
Prahlad.
Prahlad. Prahlad. Okay. Prahlad Narasimha. Now, what is this picture? Who is this two?
Sir, he is Krishna ji.
And?
Arjuna.
Arjuna. Okay.
See, I request for you know the Shiva Chandra Moli and like the other person who were chanting like who were reciting slokas and translation. Please, I request if you want to answer, you can raise your hand because we need to give chance to other people also, right?
Okay.
So devotees are very, very dear to Krishna. So Krishna is like their friend, like their father. Okay, Krishna takes the personal care of the devotee. So usually we do the devotional services. The best process of devotional service again, these are Sravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam. Sravanam means hearing the Lord's Leela and stories. Kirtanam means singing the glory of the Lord. Smaranam means remembrance of the Lord's name and the presence. Now we are asking you to do chanting. Chanting means you will tell the name of Krishna in this Maha Mantra. Then at the same time you will hear what you are doing. So two processes will be over. Kirtan and Sravanam. Sravanam, Kirtanam. And Smaranam means at the same time you can think about the Lord. Okay. So three processes can be done with while you are doing the chanting. So this is a Hollywood actor. He has written about Bhagavad Gita. I've started reading Bhagavad Gita. Arjun inside me has started awakening. So that means when you read Bhagavad Gita or hear Bhagavad Gita, slowly your inner peace will come. Inside you'll be purified and you'll develop the very good qualities like Arjun. Okay. So this is the mantra we are telling repeatedly to do chanting. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This is the prescribed mantra for Kali Yuga. Okay, where the sin are very powerful. We need a very powerful mantra. So, I think...
Sir, may I chant 12th Adhyay?
Okay, you give your name.
Sir,
okay. Okay. One more thing. So in this chapter, Krishna had told directly about Bhakti Yoga, how to practice Bhakti Yoga, how to meditate on Krishna, which form is more important for meditation. Because some people are telling you meditate on light, you meditate on heart, you meditate on respiration. Okay. So Krishna is telling those people are not great. The greatest of them are who meditate on my personal feature. Personal form is two-handed form of Krishna. Okay, first you meditate. Suppose it is difficult for you, then you follow the four regulative principles. Okay, then slowly you will be purified and you can practice the meditation on me. Then if that is not possible, you can do something for me. You work for me. Okay. Then slowly you will be purified and you can come to me. So there are the few bhakti, devotional service Krishna told. So our main aim into is to focus on Krishna completely. And we have to accept the Krishna unconditionally. That is the main thing what Krishna told in Bhakti Yoga.